Hello students, welcome back to the mathematics class. You used to observe things around you, isn't it? Most of the objects occupy space. Some objects have three dimensions: length, breadth and height. So these type of objects are called as three-dimensional objects. Today let's learn more about this solid shapes. So we are in our 12th chapter, which is visualizing solid shapes. This is the mind map for the video visualizing solid shapes. So in this chapter we would learn about faces, edges and vertices of three dimensional shapes, about nets of solid shapes, about the visual estimation of solids, visualizing solid shapes, drawing the solid shapes and viewing solid shapes from different angles. Okay, do you know what is the faces, edges and vertices of 3D shapes? The plain flat surface of the solid is called as face. Okay, and the line where two faces meet is called as edges, and the point where two or more line segments meet is called as vertex. Here I have a cube. Okay, see, you can see the faces, edges and vertices. So in a cube there are 6 faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. This is a cuboid. In a cuboid also we have 6 faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. This is a cylinder. In a cylinder there are 3 faces, 2 edges and there are no vertices here. Here I have a cone. In a cone there are 2 faces, 1 edge and 1 vertex. In a sphere there is only 1 face and then there are no edges and no vertices. Prism, there are 5 faces, 9 edges and 6 vertices. This is a triangular pyramid. So in a triangular pyramid there are 4 faces, 6 edges and 4 vertices. This is a square pyramid. In a square pyramid there are 5 faces, 8 edges and 5 vertices. In a rectangular pyramid also there are 5 faces, 8 edges and 5 vertices. Next let's see nets of solid shapes. So nets are plane figures that can be folded to form a solid shape. If we can open a solid shape, then we get the net of that shape. Here I have a box. If I can completely open this, we will get a plane shape, isn't it? That is called as the net of that particular solid shape. See here, I have drawn a cylinder here. Okay, the net of the cylinder looks like this. If you open the cylinder, it will look like this. And here there is a cone. Okay, this is the net of the cone. If you open the cone, then we get a shape like this. This is the net of the cone. Next topic is visual estimation of solids. The term visual estimation means making an approximate guess on the basis of what we see. Here you can see a figure. How many more bags of rice would be required to fill the box? See here, there are some bags here and there are space given. So we should find how many more bags are required to fill this box. Here you can place one bag. In this row, two bags can be placed. In this row, three bags can be placed. And here, four bags can be placed. So, in total, how many bags? Here we have 4, 3, so 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, 10 bags. Can you visualize the solid shape? Here, some cubes are arranged. Can you count the number of cubes here? Here, we can find 1 cube, 2, 3. Here, we have one more, 4, 5 and 6. There are 6 cubes in total here. If we come to this figure, here we have 1, 2, below this there will be 1, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and below this 8. So there are 8 cubes in total here. In order to visualize the solid shapes, we should have a very good imagination. Only then we can count the number of solids there. Next, let's learn how to draw solid shapes. Okay, so there are two methods. The first method is oblique sketches. So let's learn how to draw one cube first. Okay, for that, draw two squares like this first and then join the vertices. Here join this one and this, this and this vertices, here this and this vertices, these vertices. So if you join all these, we get a shape of a cube. If you want, you can count the faces. So this is the front face, 1. Here you can see the back face, 2. And this one is the side. This is the other side, 4. This is the bottom part. And this one is the top part. So, I have already told there are 6 faces for a cube. So, you can draw a cube like this. Next method is isometric sketches. For this, we can make use of an isometric dot paper or isometric grid paper. So, here let's try to draw a cuboid with dimensions 6 units by 3 units by 2 units. So here you can see the dots and 6 units are drawn here and here 3 units. We already drew the length and breadth of this cuboid. Now let's draw the height. Height is 2 units. So let's draw the height like this. So we completed the bottom part. Now let's see the top part. So join these lines. So the length and breadth is to be joined. So we get a cuboid. Next, let's view the solids from different angles. Okay, here I have drawn a cone here. So here what you see is the front view of the cone. And this one is the top view of the cone. And this is the side view of the cone. So here, see, you can see the front view of the cone. So you can see only a triangle here. This is the top view of the cone. This is the side view of the cone. So if you take any other solids, you can find the front, top and side views. Okay, so you take some solids which is available and try to find the top, side and front view of those solids. In this video, we learned about the faces, edges and vertices of three-dimensional shapes. We learned about nets of solid shapes, about the visual estimation of solids, how to visualize the solid shapes, how to draw the solid shapes, viewing solids from different angles, isn't it? Hope you have understood all the topics. Take care. Bye.